And Don, I wanted to go through a few of these pictures just so you could give everyone a sense of what they're looking for, how useful these might be.
Sure.
The first one I wanted to show is you can see the explosive device on the ground and what looks to basically just be a black strap around it. What would they be looking at in this picture?
Well, they're going to be looking at several things. Number one, the device itself, they'll be looking for any kind of markings that might indicate where it was manufactured and these type of things so they can trace it back. The other things that is significant about that picture, you see that black strap. What is the purpose of that black strap? Was it used as to carry the device, to help carry it, or possibly to secure something to the outside? Like potentially that's where the timing device might have been affixed to the outside of the container. Just, you know, these are all possibilities. You're just kind of scatter shooting here a little bit.
Right.
But these are certainly things that they'll look at to see if that was a possibility.
Right, right. So at least this gives you a chance to ask some of those questions that
exactly.
we didn't have before. Let me show you another one that's a little closer because you said, well, they would be looking for, you know, identification points. And when you look at this more closely, you see numbers that, and you see a UL logo, Underwriters Laboratory, obviously a certification. But it would seem like these are numbers that could indicate maybe where it came from.
Anything with numbers are good. I mean, that's going to give investigators at least a point to start to backtrack and figure out where this particular pressure cooker was made, and then from there, where was it sent? How many were sent? You know, and try to do that chain of events following that piece of equipment from its manufacturer to the ultimate retail sale. Will they get that far? You know, who knows? But, you know, sometimes you get these breaks in investigations when you need them. And so let's just hope that they will be able to at least get this particular pressure cooker, maybe even to a particular chain of stores, for example.
It
could be very, very helpful.
Right. This was bought at Sears or this was something
right.
else. And now let me show you about the photo we have of all that's left of the black bag. As you know, investigators have said, well, we know that it was a black nylon bag. And they've said that from very early on. And now we've got pictures of the shredded backpack with the white on the inside. When you look at this, what does your eye see as a trained eye?
Yeah, I mean, it looks like a mangled bag or a backpack, and you think, well, that may be just, you know, there's one in a million. But I go back to the Najib Ulazazi investigation in 2009, where we did find a whole closet full of backpacks. We were able they were intact, so we had an advantage. But we were able to take those backpacks to the manufacturer. And then from there, they were able to take us through the chain of events to say, well, where those backpacks
So they actually traced from manufacturer to point of sale.
Right. So when you think sometimes that there's no way that you can, you know, that you'll be able to figure this out, you would be surprised. Sometimes the detailed records, especially now with things with, you know, the SKU numbers and all that, you can get these lucky breaks on things.
The digital tracking.
Sure.
And then one last picture I wanted to show you is what appears to be kind of remains of melded together, whether it's the ball bearings, the small pellets, you know, what might have been the guts of the device. Is that what you think that is?
It looks to be. It's tough from that photograph, but it looks to be. And again, they'll take those and they'll compare those pellets with the pellets that were found on the scene that were pulled out of, you know, people's legs and so forth. And then they'll compare those pellets to, they'll take them to the laboratory and the FBI laboratory, the TDAC, where they analyze all these bombs. They've cataloged so much of this stuff, you know, where they've compared it to other devices. So they'll look and see if these pellets or ball bearings match other devices. Maybe they can figure out where they were manufactured too, and then start that whole process over again.
All right. Well, Don Borelli.